My dust collection installation has 4 5-inch drops with 3 5-inch connections per drop. This gives me 3 more connections than what I had in the old shop. All quick release connections on the drops are 5-inch regardless of hose size. Each connection has a blast gate. All hoses have a 5-inch connection on one end. This means I can move any piece of equipment anywhere in the shop and immediately connect it to the dust collector without modification or adapters. Hoses are long enough to allow the equipment to be moved away from the wall when working on a long piece of wood. When I move the equipment into the new shop, I use the same hoses, same length, same fittings as were used in the old shop. It only took about an hour to play mix and match to connect everything in its new location. Steel pipe, adapters, connectors, metal blast gates, and spiral reinforced wire hose is used everywhere possible because they are stronger and it maintains a ground throughout the system. The dust collector is attached to the steel building, as is the metal duct. The steel building is grounded. All electrical equipment is grounded. My dust collector is 1.5 horsepower, rated at 750 CFM at 8 inches of water. This is a dust collector. It is not a vacuum. For this to remain effective, you need to avoid restricting airflow. Dust collection is all about mass flow and velocity. The air needs to move as fast as possible. Keep the duct as large as possible for as long as possible. Long sweeping turns and laterals when you must change direction. Do not kink or bend the hoses sharply. The duct from the dust collector is 6-inch and runs the width of the shop and around the corners before reducing to 5-inch just before the vertical drops. The 6-inch 90-degree corners were made using 2 long radius L's, each turned to 45 degrees, which makes a nice long sweeping corner, which will not restrict airflow. The duct is riveted, no sharp screws were used. The joints were caulked with silicone where necessary and taped. Seams of long pipe and elbows are sealed with silicone. Eliminate all air leaks whenever possible. You want every bit of airflow delivered to the tool. I installed 5 clean-out openings. This is a Murphy's Law thing. If you have them, then you probably will not need them. If you are careful about not sucking up long pieces of wood, splinters, cloth, plastic, or string, then you should not experience a plugged duct. My dust collector is located outside and returns the air to the shop through the 4 large filter bags you see in the photos. This is done to return heated air to the shop in the winter and cool air in the summer. Otherwise, this system would suck all the air out of the shop in a matter of a few minutes. This is a one-man shop, so generally only one piece of equipment is running at a time. This system will, with some exceptions, support 2 pieces of equipment running at one time. The only 5-inch hose used is for the table saw. The table saw came with a 4-inch port, which I cut out and converted to 5-inch. The router table, miter saw, joiner, spindle sander use 4-inch hoses. The planer, drum sander, band saw, and drill press table use a 3-inch hose. The disc belt sander has 2 2.5-inch hoses with 2-inch connections to the sander. Do not use hoses which are longer than necessary. Hoses have a corrugated interior which is rough to airflow. Some of the adapters on the equipment are plastic and I converted them to use metal quick connectors. I stripped out the end of the spiral wire at the end of each hose, bent it into a loop, and riveted the loop to the metal hose adapters. I used a washer under some rivets if the wire was under a bit more strain. This grounds the hose to the metal duct. For all the powered hand tools, I try to use the shop vac and cyclone separator whenever possible. Do a demonstration on picking up this pile of planer shavings and sawdust. I'll pick it up with this 3-inch hose. It will go around to the dust collector. The air will return to the plenum and return to the shop through the filter bags. that remaining piece is a rock, which I didn't want to pick up. I sometimes put a rock inside a plastic bag on my collection drum to keep the bag from being sucked back up into the cyclone. This time we're going to pick up the same pile of sawdust. It's going to go into a 5-inch hose that came off of the table saw. Go into the lateral, comes up, goes into the dust collector. The air returns into the plenum and back to the shop.